Hello everybody, Crips here and welcome. So what are we working on today? We're working on EPS files for Boris Graffiti 6.1. So let's do that. So I'm using Adobe Illustrator and I've created something simple. See, I wasn't lying. All right, now before I import this, I did have a few issues with this. So therefore I contacted Boris himself and John and his team were really great helping me out. What my problem was, I need to create outlines before Boris can identify this. You can't see this because it's a flat image. So I need to create outlines. So I'm going to type and then create outlines. And now the object has outlines. Voila, isn't that crazy? All right, then what we need to do is we go to File, Save As. Make sure it's EPS because by default, it'll be Adobe Illustrator. Give your project a name. In my case, I've called it Triple T. Why? Because I'm lazy. And then here, where it says version, choose Illustrator 8 EPS and click OK. All right, let's launch Boris Graffiti. Here we are. And over here, you'll see a little tab called EPS. So click on that and let's look for the Triple T file. And bam, there it is. How simple is that, huh? How simple is that? And you say, yeah, but why can't I just use the text editor with Boris? Well, you can. I'm not asking you not to. But let's say, for instance, you have a logo on some product. You can then trace that logo out in Adobe Illustrator and import it straight into Boris. You don't have to try and guess it. It's there. Perfect. Now, this is an object after all. So you can create anything in Adobe Illustrator and import it as an EPS file. Round objects, spheres, whatever you can think of, you can create, you can import, so long it's an EPS format. Now, once I have this, I can turn this into extruded text. Let's do that. 3D extrusion. So there you go. And this is why I didn't really care about the color because I was going to change it into the plastic by default anyway, as soon as I went into the extrusion. So there you go. So that's kind of cool. And if you want, you can also then play around with each letter. We do that. Go to Silhouette, where it says EPS. Turn that into a spline object. I've shown you how to do that in one of my previous videos. If you open it up, you'll see them all now in their own separate track line. So you can have some fun changing each letter independently. And if you want to really get in on it, go to your pen tool, and you'll see all the nodes come up. I'm going to zoom in on that. All the nodes come up and then you can then change these nodes. If you hold down the Alt key anywhere along the line, press once in with your left mouse button, it adds a new node. So that's pretty cool. Let's go back to the way it looked when I first imported it. So there you go. That's how easy this really is. And then you can have a ton of fun with that. So while I'm here, a lot of you have asked me, lights. What about lights? I see the light tab. What does it do? All right, let's go. Make sure you highlight it. I'll close all this onto the actual spline track and then click the lights tab. And you can't see any difference at the moment because this here, let's zoom in on that. That is the light track position, but it's also the pivot point position. So they're overlapping each other. If I move this slightly, then you can see it. I'm going to zoom back out. Move left and right, and then you can see that I'm physically moving a light over my text. And over here I have options of adding three more lights, and I can position them anywhere that I want to create an effect. I can animate the light as if I want to, like if I'm doing some form of text and I want the light to be animated, I can do that just by moving this little cursor around or the little target around. And that is how the lights work. And that is how simple everything really is once you know how. Right, now for those who are using Corel, if you were to import this the way it is now, let's make this look a little bit nicer. So when we import it, it looks kind of cool. Yeah, that looks all right. Okay, I'm going to import this into my Corel Video Studio. So I'm going to press Apply, drop down this into the overlay track and pick a little clip from somewhere And there it is. Now, look what happened. I can't see my clip anymore. I'm into project and my clip is hidden. If I double click, I go to mask and chroma key. Yes, it's ticked. So why is the black not disappearing? Well, I'll show you why. Let's close that. Let's go back into customs filter. What's happening is you're importing the black background from Boris. Background here, uncheck the eyeball, press apply. And voila, there it is. And you can animate it and do whatever it is you want. Like I said, you can add anything you create in Adobe Illustrator can be put in here. So there you go, my friends. I hope you learned something new today. And as always, thanks for watching.